So hi, I'm Kevin Lewis. Welcome back to our masterclass on data governance with AWS. And now we're going to talk about building a data governance roadmap. And what we're going to emphasize is to build an effective data governance roadmap, it is best to fold it in and include it as part of an overall data strategy roadmap. Because we've talked multiple times now about the most important thing, which is aligning the data governance program to business initiatives. And that is the same thing to do with a data strategy. So any good data strategy is aligned directly to the business initiatives that it supports. And so we want to make sure that the data governance roadmap really isn't a separate thing. It is really just a part of the overall data strategy, all of which is driven by business initiatives. Okay, so we're going to talk about what a structure looks like. And what I will tell you is that the structure of a good roadmap is, again, deceptively simple. So it should be very easy to understand, but I promise that it's a very powerful technique. This can really significantly change. When we talked about a common mistake of data governance programs that are proposing their own value with their own plans, something as simple as looking at the right tracks of work that need to be within an overall data strategy, of which data governance is a part, doing that well and planning it well. If you have a roadmap that looks something like this, you're probably going to be in pretty good shape, as simple as it looks. So let's talk about that. So let's talk about the work streams that we want in a data governance roadmap. And again, when I say data governance roadmap, it's really just the part of a overall data strategy roadmap. So from that perspective, let's talk about the work streams that we want to see in a good data strategy roadmap. First, again, at the top, we want to think about what are the targeted business initiatives. Again, this is not a single source of truth or implement data catalog or anything like that. It could be, compliance related. That counts as a business initiative. We're going to, ensure that we're compliant with some upcoming regulatory issue that we need to deal with. That counts. That's a real thing that needs to be dealt with. But you have to be very, very careful. We want real business initiatives, customer experience, supply chain, claims adjudication, fraud detection, whatever it is, it's got to be something that has to do with the business. And again, look for somebody else's business initiatives, sponsored outside of the data program overall. Okay, so business initiatives, that's the first track. These are the long-term multi-project initiatives that are, again, funded programs, or very likely to be funded based on their own merit. And then we want to think about the application track. So the next track to think about is, what are the specific data intensive applications that are going to be deployed within that initiative? We do want to think about analytic capabilities, but not just, reporting and analytics and even artificial intelligence and all of those things. We do want to think about all of that, but we also want to think about targeted applications. For example, if in the area of fraud detection, there are applications that know how to sift through data and look for issues. Within inventory replenishment, there are applications that are well-trained in the idea of looking at sales and inventory and so on, and forecasting what sales are going to be and what needs to be ordered when and where. So we want to consider within the application track, packaged applications, custom applications, artificial intelligence, dashboards, reporting, the things that are going to provide direct value to the business under the umbrella of one or more of the business initiatives that are being targeted. Then in the next work stream, we want to think about the data domain. So based upon the targeted use cases within the targeted initiatives, what domains of data are going to be of interest? Again, we're not looking to deploy all of that data all at once within a particular domain, but we're going to deploy segments of that data, elements of that data that are necessary to support the near-term use cases. Again, these are things like customer data, claims data, inventory data, and so on. And then the next track of work is where we're starting to get into more of the data governance aspect. This is the data management track. So we talked earlier about making sure that we are prioritizing our data management work based on the condition of the data to support business initiatives. So here is where we're going to look at all of the data management practices that we talked about last time, and then think about which pieces of each of these need to be deployed and when, so that we can support the data in support of the targeted applications. And so this is going to help us figure out what part of these data management practices are needed. So again, if it's a customer experience initiative, and I'm looking for a next best action application, then I'm thinking about, if I have a situation where customer data is splintered across business units, then I'm going to implement an element of master data management that's necessary to ensure that the customer data is coherent enough to support that targeted use cases. And the beauty of this is that the next time we need to deploy additional customer data, we can take advantage of the work we've done for the first targeted use case and extend it and extend it and extend it from there. And then what we'll talk about in a moment is that this then guides us to what is the actual work that we are asking data stewards to do. We're not simply asking them to represent a particular domain. We are asking them to represent a domain because there is very specific work that needs to be done that they can help us with. And there's priority to this work because it's supporting a major initiative. Okay, so then it's data architecture. So here we want to think holistically as part of our overall data strategy. What's the role of the data lake? What's the role of a data warehouse, data ingestion, data access? All of the elements of the end-to-end data ecosystem that are necessary for success. But again, we don't build that architecture all at once. We have a vision of where it's going, but we build and extend pieces of it in support of the data that supports the business initiatives. And within that architecture, we're going to want to use technology to enable the data management practices we talked about. So data quality management, data catalog, security, all of these elements are going to have technical tools that are going to be part of the overall architecture that is being deployed within the data strategy. So then data security, just because it's so crucial, we elevate that and we think about that. At Amazon, we call that job zero, meaning that it's just so foundational, so important that you have to think about it before everything else. So just one way to elevate all the elements associated with data security to give it its own track of work. And then operating model. So this is the people process side. Again, I have seen many, many times where a customer will have a data governance program and the data stewards will meet once a week. They'll talk about data issues and they'll develop policies and it'll all start out very, very well, but then it kind of fizzles out over time. And why does that happen? It's because the pressure to do the work needed to support specific business initiatives is not in place. So now by making this a part of the overall data strategy in support of very targeted initiatives and use cases, now we know exactly what we are asking these data stewards to do. We are asking them to help us reconcile customer data for this use case. We're asking them to participate with us to profile data to make sure that the customer data attributes that are of interest for the targeted use case are in a condition that's not perfect necessarily, but in a condition necessary to succeed with the targeted use cases. So it takes the world of possibilities and it narrows it down to a very focused set of efforts that we're asking them to do. And we can involve additional data stewards and so on into the program, but we want to pay special attention to the ones that have very specific work to do within the roadmap that we're building. Okay, so again, when we talked earlier about making data governance a load-bearing wall underneath a business initiative, this is how to plan out that work to make that real. And so again, if you have a roadmap that looks something like this, you're probably going to be in good shape. So let me talk about an example of where this may seem like it's okay, but it's not. It doesn't work very well. And then by using this approach to these tracks of work, it can correct this challenge. And so the example is, I was working with a agricultural firm, okay, and they had just done an internal audit that pointed out that they needed a better data governance program. So it talked about data issues and challenges, and they, you know, however they came to the conclusion that this internal audit showed that there was a need for data governance. That was the situation when we arrived. And when we arrived, we looked at their data governance plan. And I got to tell you, I'm using this one example, but I see this maybe once a week. Maybe once a week, I'll see this problem. I see it so many times. So the data governance plan will look something like this. First, we're going to identify the data stewards, and then we're gonna establish a data catalog, and here's the dates associated with that. Then we're gonna build data governance capability. And they always talk about the value associated with it, and they have incremental plans, and so it seems like the right approach. But in this case, in this example, they went through, they were looking holistically at data governance, that was good, but it was a plan for data quality management, a plan for data catalog, a plan for security, and so on. One test I use when I'm looking at a company's data governance plan, I'll look at a slide deck that they're using internally to promote the program, okay? And if I were to take the name of the company off, I could look through it and ask, can I tell what this company does for a living? Can I tell what the company is? And in many, many cases, I got to tell you, if I were to take the name of the company off of the off of their data governance plan, I would have no idea what this company does for a living. And that's an indication of a very serious problem, because they're not adequately aligned to initiative. So here's the interesting thing. So you've got this plan for data governance, and this was the case in this agricultural firm. And they had all of this precision farming was the term that was used, where a lot of data is required to help optimize the agricultural process. So here there was this major transformation going on for how agriculture is done. And here you have this data governance program that is disconnected from any initiative. You put the two together. You can still take the same plan for data governance and then just look at the roadmap for this agricultural transformation, this precision agriculture that they were doing, and then align it to what are the data, what's the data situation? What are the specific targeted applications that are going to be deployed in the roadmap? All you have to do is look at the roadmap for precision farming and see what data is going to be needed and when, what is the quality situation as it relates to that data, and then take the pieces and parts of this data governance roadmap, and we help them to fold it in as part of a larger data strategy roadmap that looks just like the work streams that we've just talked about. That one simple change, and again, I do this all the time, where you'll have the data governance program with their own plans, you'll have the business with their own plans. You put the two together. It seems so simple, but it can be absolutely transformational. I said before that by aligning to business initiatives, it'll save you 2 years of struggle easily. This is a situation that I have seen go on and on for a while before they realize this disconnect. This can make a very significant. And so we're asked a lot like, well, okay, so which business initiatives do I want to target? And the first one I'll say is something that's funded or very likely to be funded. Don't forget that one. The second thing is it's best if it's an initiative sponsored by somebody outside the data program. So these things are sort of baseline. I have seen situations where there is a chief data officer who also has a second hat. That's maybe a chief marketing officer. And in that situation, it could be the same person sponsoring both, but it's in their capacity as a, let's say, chief marketing officer, not in their capacity as a chief data officer, that it makes sense. So that's sort of the base elements of what to look for: funded and sponsored by somebody else. But there are other things to look for. The data that they're deploying is very widely needed by a wide variety of other initiatives. So we talked about, let's say in retail, sales data, inventory data, supplier data, and so on, product data. If you look down the list of top initiatives, just about every one of them is going to need some of that data. So if somebody is doing a lot of work, if without your participation, they're going to do a lot of work to deploy that data, ensure the quality, et cetera, for their own initiative, then that's a really good one to engage with, because you're going to get the most reuse out of it. Obviously, the business value associated with the initiative. Now, we're talking about funded initiatives, so they obviously have already proven the value regardless, but the more business value coming in from an initiative, the better target it's going to be. Another thing is, in the real world, who wants to work with you? Who wants to participate in this program? Some initiative leaders are going to be more resistant to the help that you're offering than others. So in reality, if you're working with an initiative who is very interested in getting help and guidance for the underlying data to be successful, that certainly helps. It certainly helps if they're willing to work with you, versus an initiative that says, "Oh, we got it all taken care of. We're going to take care of our underlying data. We don't need any help." And they would see the work that you're doing more as a hindrance. So those in the real world are things that we have to consider. There's many other factors, but those are probably the biggest. So that's the road mapping. That's where data governance fits. Next, we will talk about the distribution of responsibilities and how to make that work.